sex, drugs, and rock and roll may be the calling card of many a rock musician, but Christian metal band Stryper had different goals.
I've made the decision to go out and make a stand for something different. And, you know, to run from the temptations instead of run to the temptations.
Originally a generic metal outfit called Rock's Regime, the band, brothers Michael and Robert Sweet, Oz Fox and Tim Gaines, became Born Again in 1983 and changed their tune. Stryper is an acronym for
Salvation Through Redemption, Yielding Peace, Encouragement, and Righteousness. And then if you ever saw the name Stryper, you always saw Isaiah 53:5. By his stripes, his lashings that he took, we are healed.
Even a Christian metal band needs an image, and the boys in Stryper decided that dressing like glam rock bumblebees was just the ticket.
We couldn't find anything yellow and black at the time, so we bought white and black and we dyed them yellow.
Though Stryper refrained from the evils of booze and pills, the band shared a vice common among their heavy metal peers, hairspray.
Practically a can in each hand, you know, and just every 5 minutes going back and putting more on, you know. It was unbelievable, and it was Aquanet Extra Super Hold, of course.
Instead of guitar picks or t-shirts, these Rockers for Jesus pelted their audience with a different kind of memento, Bibles.
Robert would come off the drums, and we would all go out and throw these Bibles out, and people would go crazy. The whole crowd would just, you know, trying to get a Bible.
Despite fans like Jim and Tammy Faye Baker, the first hard rock band with a Christian message faced resistance from many of their church-going peers.
Some people thought we were actually satanic, you know, and because of they felt we were being, blaspheming God with the hair and the look and the sound.
After two gold-selling releases in 1986, their third album, To Hell with the Devil, went platinum. The top 30 single honestly put Stryper on the map. At one point, the video was the most requested on MTV, beating out Poison, Motley Crue, and Bon Jovi. In 1991, Michael Sweet left the band. Later that year, the rest of Stryper went their separate ways. So where are Stryper now? Singer Michael Sweet has moved his family from Los Angeles to Cape Cod. He helps his wife run their family business, Maple Park Campgrounds.
Ranger Mike is what everyone calls me around here. And I drive a Jeep around, and basically my role here is to make sure all the campfires are out. I show people to their sites and where their hookups are, deliver messages, fill propane tanks, eat a lot of ice cream.
Ranger Mike is also Farmer Mike.
They have cranberry business as well, and they have 11 bogs, and I help with that as well. So I put on hip waders and get out in the water, and you go out there and you corral these berries that are floating on the water in, and you use these rakes.
That's something else I do. I mow the ball field.
The former Stryper lead singer has not given up music entirely. He just finished recording his third solo album, Truth. The remaining members of Stryper continue to pursue music. Brother Robert Sweet is working on a solo record. By day, Oz Fox works in an audio equipment distributor.
So basically, you've got lift capabilities to go up and down racks.
By night, he and Tim Gaines inspire local fans with their band, Sin Dizzy. Invited to play a reunion gig in Puerto Rico in 1999, Stryper found out that outside their home turf, they could still pack a stadium.
You know, and then when we pulled into the show, it looked like a football game. And I thought, what is this? And the guy said, that's where you're playing. I said, you're kidding me. Just a sea of people.
So will the band reunite to spread its message of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Hairspray in the 21st century?
I look back at some of the pictures now, and it's just a riot. You know, I'm in tears because the hair is so big. And it's like, how did we get our hair that big? I would suppose if we ever reunited, it has to be before we all lose our hair, right?
One thing's for sure, the former members of Stryper haven't lost their faith.
Jesus will be there for each and every one of you.